The long journey now reaches its epic conclusion. The Pinnacle, atop this stage, with the attention of millions far and wide. Two teams hardened by the fire of competition find themselves within arm's reach of destiny. Within grasp, their place amongst the immortal legends of the game. Welcome to the NBA Finals.
And we see the Spurs getting ready to go. The biggest stars of the line and the biggest night in basketball. This series has gone down to the line. The air is thick with excitement and anticipation. Welcome, everyone, to NBA Finals Game 7. Winner take all. A season of joy and pain will end here tonight. And thank you for making us part of your night on 2K Sports. It's the Miami Heat taking on the San Antonio Spurs. A quick check now to starting five for both teams. And now he's taking over to Dwayne Wade. What will we see from him?
And Kevin, he's really solidified his role as the closer on this team. You know, Miami struggled to figure out whether they go to LeBron or Bosh or Wade at first. I think Wade has become the guy.
Well, I tell you what, it's nice to have two guys that are capable of closing, Steve. And I agree with you, though. His aggressiveness and confidence probably give him a slight edge in closing over LeBron. You can play great defense on him, but he still typically finds a way to get the shot he wants.
Taking a look at San Antonio. They have tried mightily throughout the NBA season and now center stage exactly where they want to be. The home court advantage could play a big part, guys, in this one.
Well, Kevin, they battled to get here all season. Maybe it's taken them longer than they would have liked to in the finals, having to go all the way to Game 7. Here they are at home in front of a crowd that is just going insane. Four quarters from the title.
And now it's about centering themselves, staying focused, and keeping themselves in the moment, not allowing the emotion, the electricity, the buzz, and the energy that's going through this building right now to affect them. Because believe me, this is an emotional crowd. They're even more fired up than I anticipated they would be.
Hunter drives in, and good on the basket.
You know, guys, I would call this an astonishing double explosion. You know, he waits for the opportunity, and then boom, right to the rest of us.
To the line here.
Tony. One shot.
San Antonio on defense. They won their last game Monday night.
And if you want to look at one thing that was the key to the victory, it was the three-point shooting.
Well, that's a powerful weapon for them indeed. I mean, it makes things a lot easier for you offensively when you're knocking down that three-ball.
Well, here's Parker. Shane Battier unable to get his shot to go in. Parker drives in, and the basket is good. The call goes his way, and we could be looking at a three-point play. He made the only free throw attempt he had earlier in the game.
At the line for one.
About a minute and a half through the first quarter. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Kevin, I was able to speak with Eric Spoelstra for a moment. History may not be on their side tonight, but he said that's okay with them. They want to make a little history of their own and become one of the few teams to win Game 7 of the NBA Finals on the road. He said, believe me, this is a challenge we're up to. Let's see, guys.
And as always, Doris, thank you. And Miami calls their first time out of the game.
He needs to get them back into a flow offensively. You know, things have gotten stagnant for them. They're starting to force some of these shots.
And that can snowball on you. One guy takes a bad shot, then another guy does, and then you're missing back-to-back-to-back shots. All of a sudden, you have no rhythm and you're self-inflicting wounds.
Don't understand, hate what they can't conquer. First quarter of play with about a minute and a half gone. Chalmers, and it's blocked. And he dishes the ball. That's good.
Well, it took a while, but somebody finally got a shot to go.
You know, I was starting to get a little concerned for them. I mean, it hadn't been pretty to this point.
Oh, here's Parker. He's got six. We're off the ball from Duncan. Parker gets to Duncan. That drops, and it comes off his wrist from Parker. Duncan's got his first 2 points of the night.
Really not hard to see why they're giving up points on this run. I mean, they're just giving them too many looks inside.
Yeah, I mean, they're just getting pounded in there. The defense not offering much resistance. So we've got to force the ball back out to the corner. Now, shaky first 2 minutes against five field goal attempts, only one made.
Here's Parker. And there's the whistle. Fired hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. Mario Chalmers takes one up. For San Antonio, they have had two chances at the line.
Get a ball for two.
Free throw good by Parker. Tony Douglas is checked in for Miami.
He's always been extremely reliable at the line, and today's been no different.
And the foul called on Daniel Green. That is his first foul of the game. First team. Here's Douglas. And the rejection by Splitter. Against LeBron. Parker passes to Leonard. Beyond the arc. And Green with the basket on the assist from Leonard. Green's got his first bucket of the game and he's on the board for three. And in his first quarter, about 3 minutes played. Bosch kicks to Douglas. Parker with the steal. Only one man back on D. Touch on the finger roll. Beautiful. Parker's got 10.
They've been hot here early, dropping them in left and right. Let's see how long they can keep it going. This is quite a start.
And the Heat all time here.
This is not happy without how his team is executed. They've been on the wrong side of this run. It's time for a momentum shift.
You know, sometimes just getting off the court, taking a break, and coming back out fresh will give you a chance to pull together.
Postseason as shown on the 2K leaderboard. Fourth, LeBron James.
Well, he's almost unstoppable. He's got so many different ways he can hurt you and put the ball in the basket. He raises his level during the postseason.
Here's Douglas. Back to Bosch. Looking to number one. Rejected by the Splitter. Against Wade. Right side low. Back to Parker.
I see him.
Six on the shot clock. Outside Green. But he gets it back. Back to Parker. Double team on Parker. Leonard on the wing. Parker outside. Duncan left side. Inside. Leonard dishes to Duncan. Battier with the steal. Dwayne Wade on the wing. He kicks it to Douglas. LeBron sets the screen for Douglas. Leonard brings the double team. Lock at six. Wade passes to Bosch. And Watson is intact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Nice work. Get inside and draw the foul.
Yeah, it's obvious. The defense not going to allow many easy layups. It's going to make you earn it from the line.
And guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Spurs.
They've been making some really nice passes out there. Excellent passing. That could set the tone for the rest of the game.
Well, the other thing I like is defensively, they're causing turnovers, and that's allowing them to get into transition.
Defensively, basically no coverage. I mean, defense did not look very good there.
Leonard with a screen on Wade. A shot by Parker. Again, the Spurs good for two.
Huge advantage for them already.
And as well as they played at both ends so far, this lead might continue to grow.
That goes off the hit from Bosch. That was kicked to LeBron. And there's the feed to Douglas. Back to LeBron. Battier. And the Heat on another three.
Well, Kevin, probably his greatest value lies in his tremendous three-point shooting. When he's out on the perimeter, it gives them the ability to really stretch the defense out.
And offensively, you'll find him often lurking on those corners. Always a high percentage shot among three-pointers, and especially for him.
And here is Green. Shane Battier getting his three to go. Shot clock at six. Leonard kicks to split it. Parker outside. From deep three-point range. And the shot is good. Parker's got 15 points.
This shot is looking really good here in the first.
Sure is, Parker. He's nailing everything. 5 for 5 already.
Douglas kicks to Bosch. Wade. To get a shot off. Douglas can't hit. Spurs leading by 15. It's Parker with the drive. Here's Splitter. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. First trip to the line for him here.
Spurs. Thiago Splitter. Two shots.
Getting ready for Miami. Greg Oden, he's checked in for Bosch. Haslam comes in for Shane Battier. Michael Beasley, he's checked in for LeBron. And it's Allen in for Dwayne Wade. Second free throw, no good. The Heat trail by 16. Allen drives in. Haslam defended by Pendergrass. Here's Carter. Beasley on top.
Good boy, good boy.
Now Oden.
Hey, close out on Ray.
And out of bounds as the Spurs gain possession.
That's a poor possession. This is give away the ball in a sloppy pass.
The Spurs making a switch here. Diaz checked in. Pass to Ginobili. Off the pick. And that one's good. Ginobili's got his first points in this one.
They're really struggling defensively, giving up too many easy buckets. And they've been on fire offensively as a result.
Cole off the pick from Oden. Cole versus DeBeasley. Oden is guarded by Tate. Six to shoot. Up for any lack of athleticism with that tremendous size, Clark.
Yeah, he's not exactly a smooth operator, but what he is powerful. And when he gets positioned in the lane, he can go up and get it done.
Here's Ginobili. Greg Oden picking up that last pass. That's good. 1:37 left in the first quarter of the game. Here's Cole. Easily outside. Deeds dazzled, and he drops him a little off the glass.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early. It's going to open things up for them on the perimeter going forward, Clark.
Hunter Ginobili on the way. Makes the lead pass. Shot's good by Mills. And the Spurs lead by 18.
There it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great position inside. Yeah, getting the ball into the post should be their first option every time now. Force the defense to adapt and adjust.
That is good. Spurs leading by 16. Kicks to Diaw.
Don't leave that one open.
Nice ball to the bench in Antonio. That's a turnover. Shoot free throw. This is his first free throw of the game.
Manu Ginobili at the line for two.
That free throw goes from Ginobili. And Miami making a change here. Lewis has checked in. Good for Joe.
They're really earning their living at the line today.
The Heat trail by 18. Pull off the pick from Lewis.
Beasley.
Now passes to Cole. Lewis outside. Carries it from three-point range. Lewis has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. San Antonio's gone 3-4 on three-pointers in the first quarter, doing well from long range. Ginobili dishes it to Mills. He feeds it to Ginobili. And they'll come right back with the own three-pointer. Ginobili's got nine.
This is great. Three-pointers going down quickly at both ends. Yeah, it took them no time to answer back on that possession.
So as we end the first quarter, already a double-digit ball game. Spurs lead by 18. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment. And welcome back to this Game 7 as we get ready to get back into the action. some guys who've seen a confident-looking Spurs team out there.
Yeah, this team played an excellent first quarter offensively, moving the ball and getting a good flow to their offense. That's why you see those big assist totals.
Yeah, very timely passing for them, Steve, and that's why they've been able to jump out to this lead.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter of play. On the court right now for the Spurs, we've got Boris Diaw. Hill's out there. And Ginobili in at the three spot. And that's how you explode a gap in the Diaw guys.
Yes, sir. No soft finish there. Major power.
And he knows an opportunity for the highlight reel when he sees one.
And Miami has possession. After the basket by San Antonio.
Hey, right here.
Now, here's Chalmers. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Here's Beasley. And counting his 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
And you can feel the pattern of this game, guys. They're working it inside, dominating in the paint, getting good shots at will.
Well, four of their last five baskets, guys, have been of exactly that variety.
Looking at who's out there now for the Spurs. Pendergraft comes in for Boris Diaw. And Corey Joseph subbed in for Patrick Mills.
Come on, you're gonna miss it.
Free throw drops in for Beasley. Here's Joseph. He dishes it to Pendergraft. He passes to Ginobili. He kicks it to Bellinelli. Front pass the arc. Miami grabs the miss. Here's Beasley. Rebounded by Manu Ginobili.
I thought he rushed it a little bit, guys, because he had a clean look. Just lost his focus.
And Joseph kicks to Pendergraft. Bellinelli passes it to Day. Beasley with the rebound. The Heat trail by 17. And we're now about a minute and a half into the second quarter. And Chalmers kicks to Lewis. And that comes off the assist by Mario Chalmers. Lewis has got his second bucket of the night. Spurs leading by 14. And here is Joseph. Joseph off a pick from Day. They set the pick. Here's Bellinelli. Loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in. Bellinelli's got his first points of the game. Miami's gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Chalmers with it. Picked up by Joseph. The dish to Oden. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Oden's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Good job there recognizing the mismatch and then just going straight up with the shot. He's got a major height advantage.
Joseph dishes to Pendergraft. Now the pass to Ginobili. Offensive rebound. A second chance effort. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. They get three goals.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
There's really no room for discussion on that.
The Spurs have been good at the free throw line. This one is 7 of 8. First one falls for. A different look for Miami. Haslam comes in for Greg Oden. And it's Norris Cole in for Michael Beasley. Both free throws go from Pedigree. Time here.
like he saw some things out there that he needed to adjust it. He wants to talk it over a little bit with his club.
I don't think you can ever go wrong burning a timeout if you see something you don't like and you need to talk about it.
And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Pass on the screen. Now, here's Chalmers, covered by Mills. Allen kicks to Hazard. Good.
Boy, he made a nice little bounce pass there. We call that the pocket pass, and he did it well.
Spurs leading by 14. Joseph with the ball. There's the feed to Day. Gets to Mills. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Pocket six. And the basket by Dr. Dr's got 4 points now in the quarter. And a little under 3.5 minutes elapsed in the second quarter of play. Here's Cole. Pass to Allen. Feeds it to Hazard. Dr on him. Goes up the baseline. Hazard can't get it to go.
You know, so many games are decided by which team wins the rebound battle. And that's held true in this one so far, Steve.
And even if it's only a modest advantage that they have in that category, it's still a significant factor.
Now, here's Deal. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Sean Lewis makes one up.
You know, Kevin, Diaw is a really interesting player. He's not a big score, but he's capable. He can rebound the ball, not really a shot blocker, but mainly he's strong. He's a cagey defender, and then a playmaking big man can step out and you can run your offense through him because he's such a good passer.
Yeah, indeed. A very good passer for a big man. He played some small school when he came into the league right off the bat, and you can see some of that skill set now in his play. Michael Beasley. He's checked in for Rashard Lewis. And Diaw drops the ball. The Heat trail by 18. Chalmers off the pick from Hazard. Dishes it to Cole. Back to Chalmers. Beasley sets a screen for Chalmers. Smooth as silk on the finger roll.
Well, they've finally gotten into a rhythm offensively this quarter, and if they keep shooting like this, they won't be down for long.
Well, Steve, you can see them looking to cut that lead down little by little to turn things around, and that's how you got to do it. How do you eat a big pizza? One slice at a time.
Ginobili misses.
He hit a three in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Allen, that's good.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last four buckets allowed have come from very close range.
And giving up these easy chances is going to do wonders for their confidence.
Now here's Ginobili. He's got nine. Mills passes to Ginobili. And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back.
Heat's their first turnover here, so they've done an excellent job of taking care of the basketball. One of the reasons they have this lead.
And the Spurs with some changes. Splitters checked in for Diaw. Duncan comes in for Jeff Pendergrass. And it's Bellinelli in for Corey Joseph. Here's Cole. He feeds it to Allen. He dishes it to Beasley. Six on the shot clock. The shot no good. And the Spurs going the other way now. They led the game 1 point by 20. Duncan with a screen on Allen. Mills dishes to Ginobili. He passes to Mills. He gets it to Splitter. Splitter gets the screen from Mills. Splitter passes to Ginobili. gives him the lead pass. And the dunk by Duncan.
Dirty red shot well over the ground. I would hope so, especially when he caps it off with the steady one-handed jam.
Here's Cole. The finger roll finishes the bucket. Cole's got his second bucket. San Antonio leading by 14. Now Mills. The 15-footer, good.
Mills.
Mills has got his second bucket of the night. The Heat trail by 16. Here's Cole. And an outside. Pass it to Cole. Swiped away. And Mills kicks to Duncan. Pass to Ginobili. Has him on him. Mills dishes to Ginobili. And it's wide right. It's off the rim.
Well, he's wide open there, but really struggles from that range. Maybe there's a reason he's open.
Another shot. Cole with the rebound. For Miami, they're gone 7 for 10 here in the second quarter. You'd like to keep up that nice pace. Here's Allen. Solid defense here from Ginobili.
That's terrific defense right there to prevent from converting in close.
And Bellinelli kicks to Mills. Offensive rebound. Splitter passes to Ginobili. Mills. Splitter dishes to Ginobili. Shot clock at 6. The pass to Duncan. And that one's good. Duncan's got 8.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
Yeah, it's a strategy that has served them well in this opening half part.
Here's Cole, and he's knocked off, forced by the D. The foul call. He'll shoot free throws. One on Ginobili. The Heat shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight. First free throw is good. Chris Bosh has checked in for Miami. Both shots good from the strike. Spurs leading by 16. And Joseph gets to Ginobili. Splitter. There's the dish to Joseph. The feed to Duncan. Ginobili outside. And stolen by LeBron. .132 left now here in the second. Gets it to go.
Get off to much of a start early on, but he seems to have shaken off the rust here in the quarter.
Now here's Joseph. Splitter kicks to Bellinelli. Pass to Ginobili. The 11-footer. Chris Bosh with the rebound.
I don't know if it's just me, but he's looked a step slow since the start of the quarter. His shooting has really suffered.
The shot's good from LeBron.
Boy, that floater takes such a nice touch.
There's 57 seconds left to play in the first half. And here is Joseph.
Get down, Duncan, get down!
Back to Duncan. Kicks it to Splitter. He's up against Bosh. 5 on the clock. A jump hook. Splitter misses. The Heat trail by 12. LeBron with it. Now. Oh!
Beautiful. Wow.
Even when they're down, he's still looking to do the spectacular. And he pulled it off.
Well, maybe, yeah. maybe this is the best time to do it.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, now's when they need a little spark anyway.
Here's Joseph. Following the score by Miami. Ginobili off a pick from Splitter. Ginobili dishes to Splitter. And nothing is falling for him right now.
He's always going to have a difficult time finishing when the defense is in his face like that.
It's LeBron with the drive. He's covered by Ginobili. And there's the call on Ginobili. That'll be his second foul of the game. Here's Wade. And that shot misses everything. Air ball on the three. And so that brings the first half to a close. It's the Spurs. They're up by 10. Live from the AT&T Center in San Antonio, you're watching 2K Sports.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
An entire season has come down to this. It's Game 7 of the NBA Finals. Nothing more needs to be said. San Antonio on top against Miami. They're looking in total control, up big in Game 7 of the NBA Finals. Tony Parker having himself a big-time game. What he's been able to do from the field has been nothing short of spectacular. Only a select few players in the league can shoot the ball like that. And a tough matchup, but the Heat staying afloat. Their second unit giving them instant offense. They've gone to their bench for scoring, and they've answered the call. Norris Cole with some valuable contributions. Rashard Lewis also kicking in. And that does it for us here in the studio. Thanks so much for joining me. Now, back out to Kevin and the gang.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And welcome back to our presentation of the NBA Finals as we get going again.
What a game for Tony Parker. 15 points, and he's managed to get four of his points by way of the free throw line. And that may not be the first thing people notice about his performance, but those are important points nonetheless.
One for Miami, the one who they've got out there. Chalmers and D-Wade are the guards. Chris Bosh is out there with Shane Battier, and it's LeBron in at the three slot. Now, here's Green. Back to Leonard. Feeds to Splitter. Six on the shot clock. Releases. Misses off the left iron. And that'll be San Antonio as it goes out of bounds. Spurs retain possession. Leonard, the pass to Green. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. Parker with it. Outside Leonard. Just four to shoot. Fires from 18. And that one hits back iron.
Well, the shot was there for him, and he had to take it. I don't care if he didn't convert. He's got to take that every time.
And Chalmers gets to Wade. From out on the wing, he's watching down. Parker's got the first points of the third quarter up on the board for San Antonio. LeBron takes the screen for Wade. Shines off. Nice D from Wade.
Great job defending the hoop there. So important to have good presence defensively inside.
Green dishes to Splitter. Stolen by Wade. Bosh against Duncan. Bosh kicks to Wade. Wade, right side. With the fadeaway. They grab the wrong miss. LeBron outside. He's covered by Leonard. Second shot opportunity. LeBron with another miss.
You gotta give them a lot of credit for the job they've done on the back end.
Now, they've done a lot of things right, and I agree with you, brother. Their rebounding is right there at the top of the list.
Now, here's Parker. 17 points in the game. Back to Green. Let's it go. And it's good on the assist by Parker. Parker's got 4 assists in the game.
Well, he's a spot-up shooter, one of the best. He's one of those guys who, if you give him an inch, that's all it takes. He will let it fly and frequently knock down that shot.
And he's very much a student of the game in terms of getting to know the tendencies of whichever player he's guarding on any given night and then gearing his defensive game plan to do what he needs to do to stop it.
His third basket of the night right there.
And this offense needed that one after 4 misses to start the half.
And San Antonio calls the first timeout of the game.
Yeah, guys, I think he feels like he can make a few improvements during this timeout. He's trying to make a couple of adjustments, get his club back on track.
You know, coaches are always tweaking and tinkering with things mid-game. Actually, sometimes they overdo it.
The Heat making a switch here. Hazard's checked in. Wade against Ginobili. Ginobili off a pick from Leonard. Parker against Chalmers. Parker dishes to Ginobili. Off the mark there with a 3-point shot.
And he's having all sorts of problems with his shot. I'm not sure he even has a shot right now, Steve, to be quite honest. Not a reliable one anyway.
Rejected by Battier. Chalmers with it. He's picked up by Parker. Ginobili against Wade. Shoots from 14. Rebound San Antonio. Leonard's got 3 rebounds so far in the game.
He's been an absolute non-factor. 0 factor this game. Just a horrible performance from him.
Now here's Ginobili. He's got 9. Parker drives in. Ginobili. Here's Duncan. Shot misses. Some solid defense from Battier. Chalmers against Parker. LeBron kicks to Hazard. Again, the miss by the Heat. Spurs leading by 14. Pass to Parker. Back to Ginobili. Baseline try. Again, the miss by Ginobili.
Been a poor shooting performance for him today, but luckily for them, a lot of his teammates have come through.
Haslam, the pass to Chalmers. The pass to Wade. LeBron outside.
Man, that was unreal.
Mark it up. Forget about going for the long-range bomb to cut into that lead. Just take it to the hoop, my friend.
Oh,
take it to the hoop.
And how, Clark. Brilliant throwdown.
Yeah, just exerting his authority out there.
San Antonio's got fewer than half of their 3 corners to go down tonight. They're 4-for-9. Ginobili off a pick from Split. Ginobili kicks to Parker. Outside Leonard. Spurs whipping the ball around now. Ginobili gets the bucket.
You know, defensively, you cannot forget about him. He gave him a wide open look there.
here's Jones. He's got six. Dish out to Haslam. Now the feed to Battier, and he lays it straight in. Battier's got five.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop together.
I think it's time to make some adjustments defensively, Buck. I mean, what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
Now here's Parker. 17 points in the game. They got the rebound.
Nobody anywhere close to him. Where's the defense? He's got to make that shot, though.
Here's Chalmers, and they will get the basket here, folks, as they rule goaltender.
He got there late, but you do have to like the aggressiveness to go after the block. But that one's going to count.
The fans don't like that call one bit.
Well, the officials got an earful as a result.
Chris Bosch has checked in for Udonis Haslam. Spurs leading by 11. Parker dishes the splitter. Green. Pass to Ginobili. Shoots it up. Rebounded by Battier.
Well, he's been trying to add that mid-range shot to his arsenal, but it still isn't there.
Douglas, the pass to Bosch. LeBron. Kicks it to Douglas. Back to LeBron. Feeds it to Douglas. And he's out of bounds. The Heat able to retain possession here.
Yeah, so close to picking that pass off, guys.
At least he got a hand on it. He did what he needed to do to make sure it didn't hit the target.
And Miami making a change here. Chalmers has checked in. And Bosch backs down. Lock it two. Tried to dunk it in, but he misses.
Well, they were ready for him right there. I mean, totally collapsed the defense on
him. Now, here's Joseph. He's guarding close. That doesn't hit either by Ginobili.
It seems like nothing is falling for him this quarter. He's really out of his rhythm.
LeBron gets to Douglas. Back to LeBron. Bosch, that's the pick for LeBron. And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession. Some changes here for the Spurs. Duncan comes in for Splitter. And Tony Parker sucked in for Corey Joseph. 5 to shoot. Leonard against LeBron. And again, it's the Heat missing.
Boy, he got a nice-looking stroke. That almost went in.
Yeah, a lot of times, he'll hit that shot regardless of the defense.
Green kicks to Duncan. Working on Bosch. Baseline jumper. Duncan can't hit.
That's not a sight you see very often. I mean, he has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when he's open.
1:32 left to play in the third. Chalmers dishes to Douglas. And that comes off the assist by Mario Chalmers. Douglas has got 5 now. San Antonio leading by 9. Back to Duncan. Dishes to Leonard. Leonard off the pick from Ginobili. Leonard attacking. Get off the shot. 24-second violation. Borrego, he's checked in for Dwayne Wade. The Heat trail by 9. Now here's LeBron. 6 points for him. Back to Bosch. He feeds it to Douglas. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the strike for 2.
Yeah, he got whacked. Should be much to beat on that one.
Yeah, that was as straightforward as it gets, guys.
Miami shooting their 6th and 7th free throw attempts tonight. And the first one drops. There's 45 seconds left in the third quarter. And here is Parton. He's got 17. He dishes it to Ginobili. He gets the splitter. Back to Ginobili. Back at six. Ginobili off a pick from Splitter. Ginobili with the ball. He's picked up by LeBron. Stepped back on that one and let it fly. 14 points for Manu Ginobili. The Heat trail by nine. LeBron with it. 6 points for him. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there. This is his first chance at the line tonight. Free throw good, LeBron. And Miami making a change here. Both free throws. And here is Parker. He's got 17. And he banks in the lane. Parker's got 4 points this quarter.
Well, I tell you what, he's having one of those days where he takes it, he makes it.
And we've watched three so far in this one. Spurs lead by nine. And we're coming right back after this break to get the fourth quarter underway. Moments away now as we welcome you back. Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for the Spurs.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous.
And how about the touch they've displayed from long range, guys? I mean, as a team, they are really shooting the ball well and executing from the perimeter.
Green teams with Leonard on the wings. Down low, it's Duncan and Splitter. And it's Parker in at the point guard position. That's the San Antonio Five. Now here's Parker. Leonard. Covered by LeBron. Tries to keep it alive. Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. Outside Bosh. Back to LeBron. And he has space. And there's another one for the Heat.
It's got to be nice for them to know that game in and game out, his offense is going to be there for them.
Parker against Chalmers. So he draws the foul on the shot. Nice trip to the line to shoot two.
Obvious foul.
Right there and earn those free throws.
Spurs. Two shots.
Free throw good by Parker. Adams and Overs checked in for Kawhi Leonard. Seven. And the foul will be against Tony Parker. That is his first foul of the game. Bosh is screen on Parker. Charles with it. He's picked up on Parker. Wade working against Ginobili. Let's go. And another basket for Miami.
Boy, the deeper we get into this game, the more offense we're seeing.
And that goes for both teams, Steve. Everybody's firing on all cylinders right now.
Green, Tony.
Oh, here's Parker.
Ginobili, Ginobili, Ginobili.
Outside, Green. He passes it to Ginobili. Spurs passing it around. Launches a three. Here's Spurs. Lays it up, and in spite of the excellent defense at that. And the Spurs lead by seven.
LeBron outside. They double him with Green. And the call will be against Tony Parker. That's foul number two for him. Kawhi Leonard's check in for San Antonio. Bosh passes the ball.
You can see the correlation.
It's stolen by Wade. Passes it to LeBron. Rejected by Leonard. Parker with it. He's picked up by LeBron. Outside, Ginobili. That doesn't go either by Ginobili. The Heat trail by seven. Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Here's Chalmers. It's held in by Tony Parker. Parker's got his 6th rebound on the night. Some solid defense from Battier.
I like the work there, contesting that shot that looked like it was going to be easy, but they forced the miss.
You know what? He got it in close, but couldn't finish in traffic.
Six in the field so far in the fourth quarter. Ginobili against Wade. And Chalmers gets the bat in.
You gotta look to move the ball inside more active. The three isn't there like it was in the first half, so you gotta be able to show some balance in the offense. If the three's not there, take what the defense gives you.
Letters are like a two split. Off the screen. And a quick pass off the rim that sinks right in. And the Spurs lead by 9.
That's just a case of two teammates working perfectly together. One setting the screen and the other using it to get that separation.
Bosh kicks to LeBron. They need this one. Well, they recover it. Here's Wade. And another shot. Duncan with the puck. Now Parker. Outside Leonard. And it's good in the assist by Parker. Parker's got assist number 5 here tonight. The Heat trail by 11. It's LeBron with the drive. At the Chalmers. And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession. Here's Bosh. It's back to Battier. Cross the three-pointer.
That is his shot, guys. So you can't just give it to him. You've got to get up on him and get into his airspace there.
San Antonio calls timeout. Doris?
Kevin, Greg Popovich was just going over the plan with his team. He told his team to keep looking for three-point opportunities, saying their perimeter defense isn't doing a good job getting out on our shooters. So let's keep firing away until they decide to guard us.
Now here's Parker. Ginobili dishes to Parker. Drop the pick from Splitter. Parker passes to Ginobili. tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Pass to Wade. And that comes off the assist by Mario Chalmers. Wade's got 4 points now in the quarter. Spurs leading by six. Brought the pick from Splitter. Parker kicks to Leonard. Ginobili outside. Stolen by Wade. And here we go. Fast break. Wade's got it. Oh, and there's the one-handed jam.
Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
Yeah, it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
Ginobili with the three, and that one's good.
That's how it becomes effortless for him when the D is so relaxed. They got to get more intense.
The Heat trail by seven. Here's LeBron. And the whistle blows. It'll be on Tiago Splitter. That is his first foul of the game. Chalmers against Parker. Six on the shot clock. And the call will be against Tony Parker. That's his third foul of the game. Spurs on defense.
Chris Bosh taking two shots.
Transition basketball, the steal and the quick push.
Steve, that's how it should be played. I mean, rapid fire basketball.
Parker drives in. Now the dish to Splitter. Outside Leonard.
Parker.
Ginobili on the way. After Leonard, shot clock at five. The feed now to Duncan. Chris Bosh with the rebound. Bosh has got 7 rebounds in the game. And they double it up with LeBron. Shot from the wing. And another basket for Miami.
Well, you knew the run would come. And here it is. They're playing well now, trying to get back in this thing.
Yeah, pretty good comeback effort here. Rolling along nicely. And they've gotten themselves within striking distance now.
That took just right. And that's 23 points for Tony Parker.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the league.
And the Heat call time here. Look at Tony Parker. What a contribution.
He's on fire. They needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hand.
Checked in for Splitter, and it's Austin Day in for Tim Duncan. gets it up on the inbound. And there's Mario Chalmers on the assist by Battier.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting in the paint and keep scoring points. Keep it going.
Yeah, not a lot you can do defensively when they continue to get the ball inside and get these easy shots.
Looking at the numbers for Ginobili, he's got 17 points and the three-pointer is really dropping for him. He's got three of them.
To make them. I think they should make it more of a focal point of this offense.
The first one point.
He hasn't been quite able to lure the defense into fouling him as much. Hasn't been as effective in drawing fouls here.
Splitters checked in for San Antonio. Duncan comes in for Austin Day. So he picks up just one from the line that time.
I'm sure he'd like to have that one back, but making it a two-possession game was the key, and he got that done.
Chalmers passed away. Somehow ignores the tight D and gets the weight. Wade's got 10 points now just in this quarter.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know it by how he finished. That's a nice hoop there.
Guy with the punt fake, saw the move right there. 25 points for Tony Parker.
I'll tell you what, he's made one or two of those in his career.
Now, that was an incredible reverse throwdown right there. Tremendous body control.
I'd even go as far as say, Clark, that was a punctuation dunk.
I can feel that.
Send a message.
A message and put it on the highlight reel for later.
San Antonio with the ball. Following the score by Miami. Kicks it to Splitter. Ginobili outside. Shot clock at six. Parker dishes to Ginobili. Here's Leonard. Miami grabs the miss. LeBron's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. And it's Wade penetrating. Pass to Battier. LeBron James on the way. Feeds it to Wade. Pass it to LeBron picking up the assist. 12 points for Dwayne Wade.
Now, it looks like he's starting to get things going here after that scoreless first half.
Duncan with a screen on Chalmers. Here's Parker. Here's back up. Foul called that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Yeah, he got whacked.
Shouldn't be much difficult. It was as straightforward as it gets, guys.
Shots. The Spurs making a switch here. Green's checked in. And so he drops it off. It's a two-point ball.
Getting it done at the line as he usually does. And that could be huge in a tight game like that we have here.
The Heat with the ball. Here's Wade. There's another one for the Heat.
He's been absolutely phenomenal here in this close game. I mean, making all but one of his eight shots down the stretch. That's huge.
I see you.
Now here's Parker. Duncan with a screen for Parker. Battier with the steal. With the lead pass. LeBron. And Chalmers gets the box. Picks it out to LeBron. Chalmers pass to LeBron. Back to Chalmers. Good ball movement here by the Heat.
This is exactly what happens when you allow Chris Bosh to get going.
This is a huge possession.
You've got to execute under pressure and see what you're made of.
On the floor for Miami. And the Rams is Dean Wade and LeBron James. Shane Battier is out there with Chris Bosh. And it's Chalmers in at the line. Now a timeout called by Miami. They look to start a new streak after losing on Monday.
And the result of that game seemed inevitable because they struggled most of the night. What was a surprise was how close the game actually was.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, it looked like they had spaghetti legs, no lift. Everything was kind of limp, no life, just a general lack of energy.
Now you shouldn't be scared, I'm good at repairs, and I'm under the snare, it's tangible. But you didn't think, so I command you to panoramic view. Look, I'll make it all manageable. Pick and choose, get in news, all you different crews, chicks and dudes, who you think is really kicking tune. Picture you getting down in a pigeon too, like you lit the fuse. You think it's fictional, mystical, maybe spiritual. Hero who appears in you to clear your view when you're too
bad. Well, I'll give a look now for San Antonio. Boris Diaz checked in for Splitter. Austin Day comes in for Tim Duncan. And it's Bellinelli in for Kawhi Leonard. And Chalmers kicks to LeBron. There's the feed to Wade. Back to LeBron. For three. Knocked away. Time expires and we're going to overtime. Live from the AT&T Center in San Antonio, you're watching 2K Sports. Well, if you love great competition and neck-and-neck basketball action, this one has been a great one. Overtime number one. Getting going right now. And the Spurs start out with the ball. And always a good ride in these post-regulation battles. This overtime now looking to be an exciting one. All through the ready to go to overtime basketball here, brought to us by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the court. On the floor for Miami. Charlie are the guard. Shane Battier is out there with LeBron James, and it's Bosh with the five down low.
One quality of his that really stands out is his skill as a screen setter in the pick and roll. Actually, he's good on both ends of that play, but I really like putting him in that situation.
And Steve, you know, being a good finisher in the pick and roll requires timing and athleticism, and he's got both.
Miami trailing. Chalmers with it. Bosh kicks to LeBron. He dishes it to Wade. No good. Great D that time from Green.
They've been strong on the board. There's no disputing that.
That's what the box score says. Still anybody's game though.
Duncan with a screen on Chalmers. Parker passes to Leonard. Back to Parker. Mario Chalmers gets the whistle that time. That will get him his fourth foul of the game.
Tough call there and a tough break for the defense.
But you know, I think you could still see him kind of sliding in there. I don't have a problem with the call.
Green kicks to Parker. Back to Green. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
You know, size-wise, this is not a great one-on-one matchup for him, but he got that shot to go.
But you wouldn't know about how he finished. That's a nice hoop there.
At the line for yours, Daniel Green.
Free throw, good Green. The Heat trail by five. And the foul is called on Daniel Green. That's his third foul of the game. Overtime still getting started here, just about a minute in. Chalmers does his debating. He passes the ball. Stolen away.
He was just waiting for his chance to make a play, and as soon as the pass was made, he got it. Great steal.
Parker passes to Leonard. Tipped. Duncan, he's guarded by Battier. Here's Leonard. Baker with the jumper from the elbow. They got on this really a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. And so here is Miami. Chalmers with the screen for Lane. Chalmers picks it up to the ball. And he against Duncan. LeBron outside. Pass to Bosh. Shoots over Leonard. Blocked.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound category. They've got to continue to work on the glass.
Yeah, I agree with you, Steve. I mean, they're on the right side of the ledger, and that is all that matters to them right now with the rebound.
And the shots continue to fall as they try to put this thing away.
Yeah, big run here, and they've got their opponents in the rearview mirror.
Now, here's Battier. Here's Bosh. Misses, and the play spell continues.
Well, he hasn't had much success shooting the ball, but it's not too late for him to get it turned around and start contributing.
Duncan with a screen for Parker. Green, Wade is covering. And Green with the basket on the assist by Parker. And it's a 12-point San Antonio lead. The Heat shooting at 50% in a decent group. Chalmers with it. He's picked up by Parker. They double him with Green. And the foul called on Daniel Green. That's his fourth foul of the contest. We're in OT here with just over 2.5 minutes gone by. Tries to keep it alive. Wide open. Rebounded by Splitter. Splitter's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Now here's Parker. Drop the pick from Duncan. Parker right side. LeBron with the block. And here's the fast break. Chalmers leading the way. Rutgers this close to putting it away.
Yeah, they don't need to do anything to reinvent the wheel here. I mean, just take time off the clock and squeeze the orange. Don't turn it over.
Oh, here's Parker. Can't get the chip in. Wade drives in. Count that one.
I love when he takes the ball inside. That's when he seems to really get on a roll.
Clark, if they want to, they can milk the clock just a little bit here.
Amen. I think that's the best option.
6 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Off the pick from Splitter. Parker against Chalmers. Again, the miss by the Spurs.
What was the defense doing there? I mean, he is not the guy to give an open look to, and yet they got away with it.
The kick out for LeBron. From deep three-point range, he pins that one. Now just a five-point Spurs lead.
He's got so much junk in his trunk, he'll find a way to hurt you.
And they've done it, the new NBA champions.
You know, Kevin, you go way back to the beginning of the season and all the hours they put into this year. This is what it's about. This is what it's for. To be an NBA champion.
And the NBA season can be grueling at times, but Steve, this is the light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah, there's something so special, Kevin, about winning it at home in front of your fans who have kind of ridden that roller coaster with you, gone through all the adversity, the ups and downs, the emotions. And when you finally get that championship, it is so special when you can enjoy it with your home crowd.
And now for the presentation of the Larry O'Brien Trophy and the Bill Russell Finals MVP Award. Let's go down to NBA Commissioner Adam Silver.
Thank you to these two great teams who gave us an exhilarating 7-game final series. Thank you for the dedication, the passion, the intensity, and the teamwork. These are two very worthy teams, but there can only be one champion. So congratulations to the fans, the coaching staff, and the wonderfully talented team. Your 2014 NBA champions, the San Antonio Spurs.
This is the moment you dream about growing up as a kid. I mean, this is something that each and every one of these players will remember forever.
from the owner of the team all the way down to the ball boys. You have to hand it to the entire organization, Steve. They work together to get right here.
And what better way, Kevin, to give back to the loyal fans of this franchise than to finish out this series, this whole playoff run, actually, in front of the home crowd. What a night.
And now our attention will turn to the floor and NBA Commissioner Adam Silver for the presentation of the Bill Russell NBA Finals MVP Award.
He is a tremendously talented player and deserving of the award named for Bill Russell, the ultimate champion. Congratulations to the winner of the Bill Russell NBA Finals Most Valuable Player Award, Tony Parker.
What a moment it is right now to see the team who played so well together enjoying Clark this NBA championship moment.
Well, Kevin, this has been a special postseason, and it's awesome to be here to witness what happened tonight.
Steve?
Yeah, guys, this is what it's all about. All the work you put in, not only during the offseason and during the season, but throughout your life. When you're a kid growing up and practicing on your driveway or on your schoolyard, this is the culmination of all those efforts. So for these players and this team, one of the great moments in their life and their career that they'll ever experience.
A tremendous season and a pleasure here at 2K Sports to be with you all season long. For Clark Kellogg, Steve Kerr, Doris Burke, and the rest of our terrific 2K crew, good night, everyone, and thanks for watching.